Salam Azerbaijan.
Salam Azerbaijan.
Salam Azerbaijan.
Salam Azerbaijan.
Salam Azerbaijan.
Okay.
Salam Azerbaijan.
My name is Sherry.
My name is Lauren Richter.
My name is Keaton Aljo. I'm a student at UA Huntsville. I'm working with the Susie Ambassadors.
I'm Kathleen Sobai, Program Assistant in the Office of International Programs at UA Huntsville.
Hey, I'm Julie Chamberlain. I work here at the University of Alabama in Huntsville. And I'm from Alabama. And
good.
I work at the Office of International Programs.
I didn't know anything before.
Yeah. What the flag looked like. That was all.
I knew probably more than most people in Huntsville because I've traveled to Armenia before.
Oh.
So I'd been to the border of Armenia and Azerbaijan and heard about the conflict there.
A year ago, I knew it was an old Soviet bloc nation near Iran and Armenia, next to the Caspian Sea. I knew it was a huge...
Azerbaijan had been part of the USSR, and I knew that they became an independent country in 1991.
Oh.
I didn't really know all that much. I knew it was a former Soviet country, and you know, in the vein of Soviet history, the independence in the early 90s and whatnot. But
that's all.
Okay. Yeah.
No problem.
Now I know where it is. Now I know that you guys have a public government and a unitary government system.
Okay, we can.
That is about all. I don't know a whole lot more yet, but I will soon.
I've learned a lot just from researching to prepare for this UC program,
uh-huh.
And also from talking to students. I've learned a lot about culture. What your economy is like,
mm-hmm.
And a lot of the history and language. It's really all very interesting.
What about people? What about us? How did you think Azerbaijan is?
I've learned everyone is really friendly. Really friendly and well-cultured.
Let's see, well, I did some research before you came, because I do that with all the countries, so yeah, just did more research on the history and heritage and political system, cultural, food, current conflicts that Azerbaijan's in. Because we do orientation sessions with our friendship families,
mm-hmm.
And with our Susi ambassadors, and go through a PowerPoint on here's where the country is, here's their general history, mm-hmm. Stuff like that, and try to give them a heads up on certain kinds of foods you may or may not like, or stuff like that. So I got to know quite a bit before you came, so I want to be a step ahead of other people, because I feel like I need to know what I'm talking about. So, yeah, and then since coming here, I've enjoyed getting to know everyone, and everyone's, I guess, very fun-loving and energetic. Mm-hmm. So mm-hmm. I know what the colors on the flags meant, and the eight, you know, Turkish...
star
groups, you know, so I'd done that, but then actually like hanging out with y'all Friday night at the birthday party, seeing how everyone mm-hmm. embraced the flag, and you know, you had flags everywhere, so I got to see a lot of national pride there, and then singing of the songs and the dances, so it was clear how patriotic everyone was, and I'm excited to know more from all of your presentations, and I'm going to learn a lot more.
Showed me how much fun people from Azerbaijan can be. I learned a little bit about as far as the art, history, music, things like that. I learned what the flag meant.
Great.
Some of the national symbols.
Uh-huh. Do you like Azerbaijanis?
You guys are great. Smart, some of the nicest people I've ever met. I'm really enjoying working with you guys.
But I know that you all call Azerbaijan the Fireland. And I know like that you all, you all, like, people live on the water, and it's just, like, very pretty, and you all have, like, lots of oil there, and Armenia is kind of, you all clash with Armenia, you know.
Uh-huh.
I know your flag is blue, red, and green, and it's so pretty.
Good. Apparently Baku is a very modern city and very beautiful city, and that I need to go see it. That's the biggest thing that I have to teach myself, what the differences are between Armenia and Azerbaijan. I know there's a lot culturally, but I'm trying to teach myself what exactly the differences are. So, and I've learned that they have very energetic young people. Okay, I know that the one color, the green, is for Islam, and then the red for social justice or something like that. I don't remember. No. The blue is for your Turkish heritage, right? Okay.
Thank you very much.